and welcome to Gary's Kitchen, and today we're going to cook some salmon. I'm absolutely amazed how many times I talk with people about fish, and they say they hate to cook fish at home. And oftentimes, when I go out to a restaurant, I find that fish is not cooked very well there either. And so, consequently, I think people have an issue with fish. They think it's hard to cook, and oftentimes when they go out, they don't like it because it's often overcooked. So today, what we're going to do is cook a piece of salmon and show you how to cook it to the point so it's just pink in the middle like it should be, moist, very flavorful. Now, I've got a piece of salmon. I'm going to end up with about a 200-gram piece in the process of doing this. What we first want to do is, I got this from the fishmonger with the skin still on, so I'm going to take the skin off. And in order to do that, what we do is actually cut through the end of the piece of fish, grab onto the end, and then get the knife at a 45-degree angle to the actual flesh, and just basically pull the knife through the fish in order to be able to take the piece of skin that's off the back, so it's come off in one beautiful piece. Also, it's important, if there are any pin bones as you run your fingers along the fillet of salmon, that you do get a pair of tweezers and just pluck those pins out very, very carefully, and it's easy to do that. My fishmonger does a pretty good job of getting them out before I even get the fillet, so there's not many to pull out in this instance. One of the most important things about fish is that it needs to be room temperature when you cook it. Oftentimes people will bring it out of the fridge too quickly and it's still cold, and especially on the inside, and therefore it's hard to get it to cook. So let the fish come up to room temperature by leaving it outside just on a towel, on a paper towel, for about an hour, and that's probably enough to bring it up to temperature. And what I've done with this piece of fish, of course, is taken the skin off, and now I want to put it on just a plain paper towel and again let it come to room temperature, and then I'm going to put another towel on top of it. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because I want this piece of salmon to end up with a nice crusty caramelized coating in the cooking process. The key here is to have a dry piece of fish. Oftentimes it's true, again, people will rinse the piece of fish off and put it straight into the pan. And of course what they're doing there is steaming the piece of fish, and so it's very moist all the way around, and there's no way that you'll end up with that beautiful caramelized crust on top. And so consequently, all I've done is remove the skin, put the piece of fish on a towel, and in a few minutes after it's come to full temperature and I've let it really, really dry very well, we'll go to the stove. Okay, we're just about ready to cook this lovely piece of salmon. We're really lucky in Australia to have this amazing, high-quality farmed salmon. If you can get wild salmon, that's great. It has a different taste altogether as well. But we have Tasmanian farmed salmon that is absolutely gorgeous. So I really do like to use it. Now, what I'm also going to do with this piece of salmon, now that it's nice and dry, I'm just going to cut just a little bit off the tail, and I'll use this for my lunch in a sandwich or just in a salad tomorrow. So I end up with about a 200-gram piece that's a little bit more appealing to look at on the plate without this little skinny tail that's left on. By the way, you'll also notice that I've got pieces of salmon from the shoulder end. They're fairly thick and they're really ready to go for something like this, which are really great. Also, I've prepared a little lemon beurre blanc, which is just a little lemon butter sauce that we'll be able to put on top of it. I've also got some parsley that I'll toss into that lemon beurre blanc just before I serve it. I'll reheat this at the last minute. And also, I've got some little bits of tomato that have been cut in diamond shape that will be part of our garnish, and also just a little bit of lumpfish caviar, which will be a wonderful little topping that'll give it a bit of salt as well. You could put extra lemon juice on if you wish, but today I'm not going to be doing that. So we're ready. Let's take it to the stove. Okay, we'll bring the fish to the stove now, and what we're going to be using is a non-stick pan. And what's really important is, of course, that we do a little bit of oil. I'm using olive oil today. You can use any kind of oil, safflower oil, peanut oil. I'm using olive oil. About 2 tablespoons have gone into this non-stick pan. Now, what's really important about non-stick pans is one very simple thing that I only learned fairly recently. I've been cooking for years. And only recently did the guy who is a friend of mine at my cookware shop told me some information about non-stick pans. When you heat a non-stick pan to beyond 250 degrees Celsius, the pan goes from non-stick to stick. It actually changes the chemical composition somehow in the surface, and you can ruin your pan. So it's really important as you heat it up to really high heat, because we want to caramelize the fish to give it that wonderful crunchy crispy outside, that we don't make the mistake of getting beyond that temperature. So one of the things I do, and one of the things I use that's going to be laughed at by a lot of professional chefs, is I use a laser thermometer. This gives me the ability to constantly check the temperature of the oil in my pan, the cooking surface in my pan. I'm going to heat this up to 200 degrees Celsius as a minimum, a little bit more if you want, but you can see how, if you're not careful, you heat it up too high and ruin your pan and also make it hard to cook the fish. So I'm gonna again utilize this laser thermometer to take the temperature up to 200 degrees Celsius. It's currently at 116. Now, the other thing that I've done, I remember earlier I had a little bit of beurre blanc, I'll just grab it, a little bit of a beurre blanc sauce that I'm now going to start to reheat on the top of the stove, which will give me the ability then, of course, to use that just at the point that I'm ready to serve it. So I've got my garnishes ready, I've got my sauce ready, I've got green beans. At the very last minute, I'll toss in a little tiny bit of butter just to warm them through. They've already been pre-cooked, and that'll be my dinner. Now, the other thing that I do that is kind of a non-chef thing is that I actually time when I cook fish. For salmon, I cook 5 minutes total. 3 minutes on the presentation side, 2 minutes on the other side. For other fish that's fairly thick, like this 200 gram piece of salmon that I'm using, I would be 7 minutes. If we're using ling or other fish, I would probably be going 4 minutes on one side, presentation side, 3 minutes on the other side. Now that's a non-chef thing. They say, no, just touch it and you know the temperature's right. I don't think that you can do that. That's why I find so many restaurateurs, so many chefs, give me fish that's overcooked. So here we go. We're currently at 180 degrees. Now remember, we're going to maintain 200 degrees in this pan and do it for 5 minutes, 3 minutes on presentation, 2 minutes on the other side for salmon, because I want it to be that underdone, pinky, almost rare sense on the inside. If you like your salmon cooked all the way through, which I think dries it out and kills it, but if you happen to like it that way, then cook it for 7 minutes. But I'm going to do it for only five. Okay, there's 204 degrees. Let's carefully place the salmon in the oil. And at the same time now, we're going to season it with plenty of salt and plenty of pepper. Now, the reason I put quite a bit of salt and pepper on is because it is true that when you cook, you lose about half of your seasoning in the cooking process. So a little bit of extra salt and a little bit of extra pepper is pretty important. Now I'm again going to be checking the temperature of the pan fairly regularly. We're currently at 211 degrees, so I'm going to bring the temperature down just a little bit, not to overheat that pan. Remembering, I want 4 minutes on one, excuse me, let's start again, 3 minutes on the presentation side and 2 minutes on the other side. So there we go. It's actually beautiful, and you can start to see it cooking as it does come through the cooking process. And you can start to see it the color change as it goes through. Remembering, we're wanting to leave this a bit raw in the middle, so it consequently isn't going to be cooked all the way through. Still checking the temperature with my thermometer. We're at about 198 degrees Celsius. Again, my sauce is now warming nicely, and the fish is cooking beautifully. And we're ready to turn this over now, and you can see that beautiful caramelized top on it. It's beautifully cooked and it's going to be perfect. At this point, we'll put a little bit more salt and a little bit more pepper. We, of course, at this point could also put a little bit of extra lemon juice on top, but we won't do that. But what I will do is just take this little tiny knob of butter and put it over the top. So I'm going to rub that as it does continue the cooking process, and that will just make that top not only crunchy, but it will also be quite moist. And we'll just let that little bit of butter just continue to be on top, and then I'll also just let it roll down the side of the piece of salmon so it picks up a little bit of butter on the bottom side of it as well. We're coming up on just about finished. Now I'm going to put the salmon on a piece of kitchen paper in order to blot it, which will also remove a little bit of that extra fat that may be stuck on the bottom. Turn the pan off so we don't forget to do that. We don't want to walk away from a heated pan. We'll now take the beautiful piece of caramelized salmon, put it on this piece of white kitchen paper, which will allow it to blot completely and be ready for plating. Okay, there's that beautiful piece of salmon that has been cooked, what I think, to perfection. And I'm now going to take a plate out of the oven, and this has been warmed to about 100 degrees Celsius or about maybe 75 degrees Celsius. I think it's really important to serve on hot plates. And also then, here's our sauce. And this sauce, again, is a little beurre blanc. It's just a little bit of a lemon butter that I'm going to put on top of it. And now's the time, of course, to put just a little bit of parsley into that sauce in order to finish it, so it's ready to go. The fish, again, has been blotted on this piece of paper, and you can see just a tiny little bit of oil has stayed there. Rather have it there than on the plate, and we're ready to plate it up. Now we'll take a little bit of our beurre blanc sauce, and we'll dress the plate with the beurre blanc sauce. Remember, this is a vinegar type of beurre blanc sauce. It could easily be a lemon one. And we'll also then put a little bit of parsley that's already been put in the beurre blanc as well on top, just to give it a little bit of a nice look, a little bit of a garnish. We'll then take these little diamonds of tomato and place them very carefully on the top, and even can spill around the plate a little bit if we want to. And then in addition, we've got that little bit of caviar that we talked about earlier. And what we'll do is we'll just take a spoon and put a little tiny, tiny, tiny bit of that caviar on top, which gives that little bit of extra crunch and a little tiny bit of extra salt as well, which is a lovely, lovely flavor. Now I've got just a few green beans that have just been heating on the stove, and they've also been seasoned with salt and pepper, and this will be our side vegetable. We'll place those on the side of the plate just up here at this top, not in the middle of the sauce. And there you have it. This wonderful piece of salmon that has been seared beautifully just in 5 minutes, and you can see how simple it is. Why on earth would anybody be scared of cooking fish? And why is it that they have to overcook fish in so many restaurants that you go to? This is a beautiful piece of salmon, in my opinion, perfectly cooked with a little bit of beurre blanc, some tomato diamonds, and some caviar. I hope you enjoy cooking it. I hope you enjoy eating it. Bon appetit!